lockers should be red, though.
I think they should be red because it contrasts with the blue lockers and the yellow lockers down the hall.
But then again, it doesn't contrast with the exit sign, which really draws your attention. Wait, let's ask Tim. Hey, what do you think on the topic?
Like most things in the universe, I'm neutral on the topic.
Hey, what if I take away some electrons and make you positive?
Oh, funny joke.
Or I could give you some so you're negative towards it.
Whoa, guys, don't short circuit.
You mean an unintended path of electricity?
Sure, I have a motors class with Mr. Wickettook.
Man, that class is like going near a down power line. You're bound to get shocked.
You might also feel like you have brain damage.
Yeah. So, are you coming over later then?
Sure, I guess.
We'll be back with science right after this short commercial break.
Hey, friend.
Have you ever gotten yourself into a sticky situation like this? How about try washing your hands? Now that's better. Welcome back to the world's favorite TV show, Science.
Hello, class. Just quiet down a little. So today we'll be talking about motors and such, and I'll tell you the four sort of main parts of a motor. So there's the magnets along the outside of the motor. Hey, could you just you look up a little? Thanks. You just look like you're going to fall asleep. And then there's the armature, which is the rotating shaft or remote of the motor, the commutator, broken ring that creates and reverses
the flow of the current.
So, last part of a motor is the brushes, which conduct electricity from the cell or the battery. Now I will explain how motors work. The electric current travels from the brushes into the commutators. Commutators magnetize the wire coil. Magnets push or pull on the wire coil. Rotation of the armature switches the position of the commutators. Cycle continues, decycle continues, until current is stopped. So, that's all you need to know about motors right now. Now we'll talk about electricity. Susie, can you tell me the difference between DC and AC?
Huh?
Could you tell me the difference between DC and AC? You clearly know it because you got 100 on the last test. Unless you were cheating.
Holy cow, I'm falling asleep.
In one direction while it holds the current flows back and forth 60 times per second.
Alright, guys, if you had to choose between two alternative power sources to power a coastal city, what would you use?
Dude's Hydro.
Be quiet.
Good work, guys. Because both of those are used yearly, all around the year.
Yeah, but you kill so many birds.
More food.
It would be expensive, but that's how we're going to pave the road to a brighter future, really.
Well, we'd have a brighter future with all the light bulbs we're powering down electricity.
Yeah.
Wake up.
someone tell me where you find DC and AC? Susie? Any?
Well, you can find them in calculators or computers such as that one we got there.
Yeah, yeah, sure. And also a radio is another good example. Very good, Susie.
Amps are more dangerous because it's the rate on which the current flows. Voltage is how much is carried from particle to particle, or potential energy. Explain how I could have two circuits with the same volt batteries, yet one circuit putting out more amps than the other circuit. Kevin, could you answer my question?
When the switch is off? Oh,
exactly,
sweet.
Right.
I answered that question. No one even thought of it yet.
It was. I'm going to hand out some notebooks in a little bit. Be prepared to work.
Have you guys seen Kevin before?
No.
In that case, he's probably dead.
Horror.
All of you are going to us.
We'll be back with science right after this short commercial break. First, they learned how to crawl around in our society. Then, they started to cuddle and form bonds with our humans. After that, they evolved to walk on 2 feet. Now they're learning from us, even if it is just dancing. So for a super kind of bear, you need Super Bear Mace. Welcome back to the world's favorite TV show, Science.
Oh man, that sleepover is going to be totally rad.
Man, that's radical.
I know, right? Who would have thought your turtle would do that?
I know, man. I worry about him these days.
Yeah, he looked pretty sick, though. But look at this. Tim must have been doing some decorating.
Like a girl!
Hey guys, are you guys talking about me again?
Yeah, and your great programming.
Hey, let's see if Tim programmed Chris good enough.
Yeah, okay.
What's your question?
Okay, which is better, current or static electricity?
Bunch of buffoons.
If you're as smart as your programmer, you'll be able to answer this.
Bunch of jerks, I tell you. Bunch of jerks. Here, tell him, Chris.
Well, of course. The answer is the current, because it lets the electricity flow, unlike the static.
It can also be controlled.
Whoa. I got one that'll stump him.
Yeah?
Yeah. What's the difference between static and current electricity?
Ha! Easy question. Chris got us again.
Static electricity is built up off of electrical charges, off of a surface, and it's uncontrolled and happens at random. A person that has contributed to the discovery of electricity was Benjamin Franklin.
Thought I had him that time.
Well, there was this guy named Benjamin Franklin. He sent a kite into the sky with a key attached to it to prove the existence of electricity. Well, guys, I'm gonna be back in a jiffy. I gotta go. Sit up on the couch while I'm gone.
Okay, see you in a little bit.
Bro, he has an electricity unit kit.
Aw, sweet. I've always wanted one of those.
He already has his parallel circuit set up.
Wow, what a geek.
Yeah, you said. I'm glad I have one of these in my house, then electricity can travel on more than one path.
Yeah, I think my house has one too. Yeah, so like, why is that any better than a series circuit?
Because series circuits can, electricity can only travel on more than one path.
Okay. Yeah. Oh, hey Tim!
Hey guys! What you guys doing? Wait a minute. What are you guys doing? You guys are just sitting here like a bunch of couch potatoes. You guys should be making circuits.
Yeah, like you're such a pro circuit maker. Look at this. He didn't even include one of the four main parts of a circuit.
What a noob.
Yeah, the switch. Yeah, along with the other four main parts, you got three, so that's like 75%. You'd be disowned in my family with that grade.
I was distracted.
See, the other parts are the battery. Yeah, you might not know this one. The conductors, which are the wires. And then last but not least, there's these little things called light bulbs that go in it, right?
Yeah.
How could you fit such a giant circuit in such a tiny machine?
Well, it's a small thing, like this. It's called a microcircuit. It's used in new technology. Transistors and resistors.
Oh, cool.
We'll be back with science right after this short commercial break.
Lemons.
Welcome back to the world's favorite TV show, Science.
So you guys know the rules, right?
Yeah, we went over it a couple times. One team asks the other team a question. If they get it right, they get to ask the other team that asked the question in the first place a similar question. And if they get it wrong, they have to pick up a punishment card and have to fulfill the task that is written down on that card.
Exactly. So, as my team is missing a member because Kevin is such an inconvenience to us, always. He never shows up to these events.
Yep.
So that's why I brought my best pal, Chris. I even programmed him myself. He's going to be my teammate.
We're going to kick that robot's butt anyways.
Okay, what's the topic?
Today's topic is electricity.
Sweet, we got this one. Okay, see who goes first. Nice old-fashioned round of rock, paper, scissors.
Ready? Go.
Okay, wait.
Rock, paper, scissors.
Oh, there we go.
You guys go first.
Off to a rocky start, but we got this one. Okay. If a product has 100% efficiency, what is this telling us? And why do no product have 100% efficiency?
I don't know this one. Chris, you got this one. Tell him, Chris. In our question to you is, tell him, Chris, you got this.
I got this. The answer to your question is, I have the answer, Michael has the answer.
Yes, let me just...
Funny, you're always funny.
It's like, when you can't create or destroy energy, you can only rearrange it, or change it, right?
Uh-huh, but the problem is...
Aw, oh, you suck.
You forgot the other half, is that energy is released by heat, sound, and light in conversions that happen. So, pick up the card.
You want to pick it? And then I can blame you for whatever we get?
Chris.
Our punishment is do math without Ben.
What are three types of cells, and explain how each gets its name?
Dry cells, wet cells, and rechargeable cells. Dry cells are what they call dry, because chemicals are in the form of paste and conduct electricity. An example of a dry cell is a dry cell diagram. These cells use liquids to create a wet cell. These cells use liquids to conduct electricity. These cells are cheaper to make, however, liquids are used to make those computers. The example of a wet cell would be a car battery. Chargeable cells. Chemical reactions can be reversed. They store energy from an outside source. An example of a rechargeable cell is an energizer to charge the battery.
What variable resistors do, and what is another name for them? Examples of where we
can use this. Resistance is how difficult it is for electrons to flow through a substance, and resistors only allow a certain amount of current to pass. The resistance is measured in ohms.
What do resistors do, and what is resistance measured?
Explain the difference between cells and batteries.
Electrons move through cells from negative to positive. Batteries are when you put two or more cells together.
They allow gradual adjustment in the form of a resistor. Another name for them is rheostats. Example.
When a switch is closed, two conductors are pressed together.
Describe what switch is in. Describe how.
Oh no, we can't play the game anymore.
We could have kept playing if you installed that lightning rod like I told you.
What was that? Stop being such an insulator.
Yeah, you should be a conductor like me.
And it seems like the resistance to Ohm's relationship is like the relationship between voltage and current. Because when Chris's intelligence goes up, then Tim's temper does too.
You guys are funny.
We should probably go solve this problem.
Alright, let's go.
We'll be back with science right after this short commercial break.
Tired of getting blood all over your paper? Aw, man, that sucks. Well, try using not paper. Only 99 cents.
Welcome back to the world's favorite TV show, Science.
Come on, let's go.
Why are we moving so slowly?
If we decrease the friction, we can increase the efficiency.
So, are we going to fix the problem?
If I apply my knowledge of electricity in this problem, I'll be able to fix it easily.
Yes, you have such vast knowledge on the subject.
What's that, Chris? I shouldn't have programmed you with that much sass. I have fixed it!
Well, the lights are on, but you still haven't fixed the problem with Chris's sass.
Well, I guess the next mystery is who drank all the delicious soda.
So, why weren't you there?
Oh, well, Mr. Wickatook was teaching me how to save energy by turning off or unplugging lights.
Yeah, we know you got detention.
So what happened with you guys?
Lots of stuff. Let's just say it was electric.
Ha ha ha!
Ha 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 ha!